So this next fill is a lot like the In the Mood lick, but it's using a sixth chord or a seventh chord. Now, this one also is going to require you to wrap your thumb around the neck, so this will take a little bit of practice. The first time I learned how to do this, I was convinced I was never going to be able to do it, but with a little practice, I was. It's just going to feel a little bit weird at first. So here's how it works. It works out of the regular D or out of the regular F chord shape, so I'm going to do it as a D chord here at the 10th, 11th, and 12th fret. But what happens is we're playing the regular chord shape, and then we're going to add an extra note by wrapping your thumb around the top of the neck to play the fifth string. Now, if I play the D chord here at the 10th, 11th, 12th fret, the note that I'm adding over here is a B note and is creating a sixth chord. So just like if you were playing a seventh chord, you can add that sixth note and get a... This is also what I always like to call the Wheel of Fortune chord. If you've ever seen that TV show, you know, they say, can I buy an R? That's the chord that plays. So Earl Scruggs used this as a great backup lick by playing the D chord shape, wrapping his thumb around to get that extra high note. And once again, I'm not going to play the fourth string on this, so in order to get my thumb around to that side of the neck, my ring finger kind of comes off of the chord right there. I'm holding down the other three strings like usual, but if I try to hold it all down, it becomes really kind of cramped. So once I've got my thumb wrapped around and I have that note, the roll goes like this. It goes 3-2-1-5-2-1-5-2-1-5-2-1-5-2-3. So listen to that one more time. 3-2-1-5-2-1-5-2-1-5-2-1-5-2-3. Let's try that along with the metronome. 1, 2, 3, 4. One more time. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now the other version of this lick is to do the same thing, but to move your thumb up one more fret and get a seventh chord sound. Now seventh chords, you're probably used to, or if you've heard them a lot, seventh chords usually indicate that a change is coming. You hear a seventh chord and it sounds like you want to resolve it back to the original chord from the song. So the seventh chord is done by playing the same chord shape. We're playing the D chord shape here at the 10th, 11th, 12th fret, but this time your thumb is going to play the fifth string at the 10th fret. And you can hear how that adds a little extra tension to the chord. So let's try that one together. 2, 3, 4. 3, 2, 1, 5, 2, 1, 5, 2, 1, 5, 2, 1, 5, 2, 1, 5, 2, 3. Let's try that one along with the click. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now while we've got the click going, I'm going to move the position down to a C chord at the 8th, 9th, and 10th fret, and this time you're going to need your thumb here on the 8th fret and do the same thing as a C chord. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Then just for fun, run it up to a G chord up here at the 15th, 16th, and 17th frets. Make the 6th chord shape where you're going to have your thumb here at the 14th fret. And let's try that one. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Thank you. Now, holding that position can really tire your hand out. The good news is, since this is a fill-in lick, you don't usually hold it for very long. You slide right into it, play the lick, and then go back to your normal vamping or other backup type playing. In the next lesson, we'll try playing this along with the chord progression.